Our brains process huge amounts of information, 99% of which is done unconsciously. Because our unconscious associations are influenced by the world around us, they can lead to implicit biases. Test results show that we tend to perceive being white more positively than being black, that men are more closely associated with science and women liberal arts, and that being heterosexual is perceived more positively than being gay. Having these implicit associations doesn't make us bad people. They merely reflect our social conditioning. The trouble is, we reinforce these biases when we are rushed or stressed by relying on knee-jerk responses rather than rational thinking. One type of implicit bias, called stereotyping, can result in a negative perception of people based on their identities. Another type, affinity bias, involves favoring people we identify with. The combination of the two can be powerful and might explain why so many leadership positions are consistently held by white people and men. Privilege is often invisible to those who have it. For example, how many of us who are able-bodied take the time to worry about the challenges that differently abled people face every day? So by acknowledging white privilege, we are simply acknowledging the different realities of people of color. Studies have shown that Black and Latinx students are more likely to leave STEM than similarly qualified white students, that women of color face the highest levels of harassment, and that Latina and Black women scientists get mistaken as janitors. The geosciences are notorious for lacking racial diversity, and the less diverse any field is, the greater the tendency to rely on stereotypes and implicit biases, and this creates an exclusionary culture. The good news is that becoming aware of our unconscious biases can help us rectify them and create workplaces that are inclusive for all. Why is diversity important? For one, the history of racial oppression in our society needs to be addressed and acknowledged. Also, more diverse groups have been proven to be more innovative in the workplace. So without diverse talent in STEM fields, we won't come up with the best solutions to the biggest issues facing our generation, such as climate change. So what can we do to take effective action? Many things. We can make hiring processes more transparent and inclusive. We can launch anti-racism initiatives. We can do salary equity studies. We can reach out to minority-serving institutions, such as historically Black colleges and universities, to build partnerships. And that's not all. What do our reward structures look like? Who gets appointed to leadership positions? At each of these steps lies a possibility to promote racial equity. Very often, diversity work is carried out by underrepresented groups without formal recognition. But if we all committed to doing this work, we can foster a collective cultural shift that produces a more diverse, innovative, and equitable STEM culture for all.